Good morning, everyone, and thanks for joining our webinar in the middle of these hard times. My name is Maximiliano Bianchi, and I am the communication manager of XF Actors Project. This is the fourth webinar organized by XF Actors Project. That is a research project to improve prevention, early detection, and control of Xylella fastidiosa through the establishment of a multidisciplinary research program. It's a four-year project funded by the European Union within the Horizon 2020 program. This webinar, our fourth webinar, will focus on the features of resistance to Xylella fastidiosa, and it will be led by Dr. Pasquale Saldarelli of IPSP CNR of Italy, giving an overview of the features of resistance to Xylella fastidiosa in grape wine and citrus. Pasquale Saldarelli, thank you for being here, is a senior researcher at the Institute of Sustainable Plant Protection of the CNR in Italy. He is a plant pathologist with main research interest in diseases of grape wine and Mediterranean crops. He described several new viruses and associated diseases using NGS technology, developed biotechnological methods and tools for virus detection. He devoted his efforts to study Xylella fastidiosa outbreak in olive in Apulia, contributing to the genome studies of Italian and Spanish isolates, to the analysis of olive response to the infection, to the description of the microbiome of olives infected by Xylella, and to the study of Xylella resistance in olive. He served in the scientific committee of the Italian Society of Plant Pathology and is member of the scientific committee of the International Council of Virus and Virus-like Diseases of the Grape Wine. He participated in several EU projects and is currently responsible of work packages in the H2020 project Ponte, XF Actors, and BioVexo. This webinar will last about 50 minutes, and then there will be a slot time for answering your question. And by the way, you can write your question using the chat in the right corner of your window. We'll collect them, and then Pasquale will answer them at the end of his speech.
Good morning to all of you, and thanks for your interest in attending my seminar, in which I will give some features of plant resistance to Xylella fastidiosa, with a particular emphasis to our studies in olive. A few reminders about what is Xylella fastidiosa. And here you have the biological cycle of Xylella fastidiosa in Peirce disease in grape vine. And you know that the bacterium needs to be transmitted by insect from plant to plant. So first approach, control to contrast the Xylella infection is at the transmission level. I will not speak about this. I will speak of the control at the plant level. Similarly, you have in olives, this is the biological cycle of Xylella fastidiosa in olives, and here you have the transmission from plants to plants that we discovered made efficiently by Phyllenus spumaris. Again, I will stress that I will speak about the control at the plant level. Just additional reminders about how the disease process progress in plants infected by Xylella fastidiosa. I like a lot this definition of Xylella, which lives in two world. Lives in two world means that the bacterium lives in the insect world, that transmit the bacterium from plant to plant and in the xylem vessels, in the xylem network of the infected plants. In the xylem network, in the xylem vessels of the infected plants, the bacterium exists in two forms, which are indicated here in red and green as non-mobile forms and mobile forms. Non-mobile forms in red are bacteria that are embedded in polysaccharides biofilm that made it sticks to the xylem vessels and induce the occlusion of the xylem vessels. But from this, I would say, mass of bacteria embedded in biofilm, some cells are released and moves systemically to infect other parts, to spread to other parts of the plants and start new infections. This process from this equilibrium, I would say, from non-mobile and mobile forms is finally regulated by a mechanism that is called quorum sensing. And as you can imagine, as the bacterium dwells, lives, replicates in the xylem network, and the xylem is a water transport network for the plants, bacteria aggregates induce occlusion of the xylem vessels, inducing a sort of stress, water stress response, a draw stress response. But in addition, besides the bacteria aggregate, also plants respond to the infections by producing tyloses, particularly that you can see here in the B part of the photo in grape, which are protrusion of the parenchyma cells of the xylem network that occlude the vessels. And this is an attempt that the plants do to isolate the bacteria and impair its progress, its movement systemically to other parts. And again, if you want to establish a control at the plant level, you have two possibilities. There is a therapeutic possibility, which is not possible with Xylella. I want to stress, up to now, there are no cure, no therapy that has been demonstrated suitable to control the Xylella replication, the Xylella infections in infected plants. So one option that we have is to try to look for plant resistance, so natural resistance to the bacterium that can exist in plants. And this resistance, this resistance exists in major crops. Here you have an example in citrus variegated chlorosis, and infections of Xylella caused in Brazil. And here you can see that the sweet orange is susceptible to the bacterium, to the infections, while mandarin and lemon are resistant. Similarly, in grapevine, Xylella resistance exists in vitis, but it exists not in vitis vinifera. To understand the vitis vinifera is for wine, for table grape, but unfortunately it exists in vitis arizonica, a wild vitis that is not good for producing wine and also table grape. This resistance in grapevine is known, is genetically mapped on the chromosome 14 of the genome of the vitis arizonica, and this indicated and is present in a locus that is called PD resistance, PDR1 locus, that has been exploited for classical breeding. As you can see here in this photo, these are five grape varieties resistant to Pierce disease. These cultivars, hybrids, has been released a few months ago at the start of 2020 of the year. They have funny Italian reminding words, names. They were produced by Dr. Andy Walker from UC Davis by crossing with classical breeding, crossing Vitis arizonica with different Vitis vinifera cultivars, Chardonnay or Merlot and so on. But these five hybrids, because they are hybrids, they have, according to what Andrew Walker said, they have 80%, 87, up to 87% of Vitis vinifera blood. And they were obtained after a long period of crossing, repeated crossing, because each time the hybrids were again crossed with Vitis vinifera to eliminate from the hybrids every as far as possible of the genome from Vitis arizonica and maintain only the gene for resistance. You can see that it took 4 or 5 generations of crossing and about 20 years of selection. We were, I would say, lucky in a certain sense, because we found resistance in olive, and we found this resistance naturally existing in cultivar Leccino. As you can see here, these photos in Leccino, we observed limited and localized desiccation, while the susceptible cultivars, Oliarola salentina, these photos, of course, are from the outbreak, the epidemic area in our region. As you can see, the susceptible cultivars are severely affected. And here you have other example of this resistance. Again, a comparison between Leccino and Oliarola salentina in the same orchard, in the same management, and you can see directly the outcome of the infection. This photo was a recent photo that we took this year, and this speaks by itself. So I don't need to add additional words, because they are taken in the very infected area near to Gallipoli. So traits of resistance exist in olive. And we found also this resistance in another cultivar, which is FS17. For many of you is Favolosa. This resistance, this photo was taken in 2016, but here you have a photos this February, in which you have the FS17, again in the outbreak area, and in the background of the photo you have a trunk of Cellina and other susceptible cultivars, which has been cut because of the severity of the infection. So these are our field observation that we have about this resistance. Now we move to look for, describe what is known about this Xylella resistance in grape, citrus and olive, and try to do some parallel, some comparison. And I will speak about the features of xylem anatomy, of plant response, and to the infection that can be physiological, chemical, or genetics. A nice paper was this from Dayet on the left, in which they assessed the Pierce disease susceptibility, that means the susceptibility to Xylella fastidiosa in different Vitis vinifera cultivars. And you can see the range of symptoms that can be induced on grape, on different Vitis vinifera cultivars, from by Xylella fastidiosa. They found that resistance is strongly linked, associated to smaller vessel diameters. And the rationale, the explanation behind this, this phenomenon was that if you consider that plants respond to Xylella infection by thallus production, so that, that means that the protrusion of the parenchyma cells in the attempts to isolate the bacteria, to compartmentalize the bacteria and impair the possibility to spread, limit the possibility to spread to other vessels. So a smaller vessel is more easily, more efficiently blocked. So the bacteria can be better blocked in smaller vessels. That's the rationale, the explanation behind this, at the base of this phenomenon. Indeed, even in the past, also the percentage of vascular occlusion is less in resistant cultivars of, compared to susceptible in Graven. So these are evidence in Graven. In citrus, again, there were no difference. Authors from Brazil, they found no difference in xylem morphology, but they found, as you can see in this photos, in these micrographs, they found, here you have that Xylella is tagged with green fluorescent protein, so GFP, so the green spots are Xylella. You can see that they found that in susceptible cultivars, Xylella is able to move from the primary xylem to the secondary xylem, while in the stem of resistant cultivars, Xylella is limited in the movement and is limited in the primary xylem. So the colonization progress, the movement of Xylella, is impaired in resistant cultivars. In addition, lignin deposition was higher in vessel from resistant. Lignin is a classical antimicrobial products that plant produce in response to pathogen infections. In olives, we found again, as you can see from these photos and also this graph, we found that the percentage of occluded vessels is significantly lower in the resistant cultivar Leccino and FS17. And again, in parallel with what was found in Graven, we found that Leccino has a smaller vessel diameters as was found in Graven, in comparison with Cellina and Oliarola, the two susceptible varieties. FS17 has not a smaller, smaller vessel diameters, and we are starting to think that, indeed, we think that he has another mechanism of resistance, because we should imagine different mechanism of resistance. These smaller vessels, the finding of smaller vessels was also reported by colleagues from the Lecce University in outbreak area. They also found a smaller vessel diameters. And they, in addition, they also found that Leccino has a better refilling mechanism. What does it mean? In a sort of plant reaction, the starch is hydrolyzed by in Leccino, producing starch grains that are these sort of bubbles that you can see in the vessels. The production of these starch grains determine an osmotic flux of water, so that from the cells to the vessel lumens, that in a sort of refilling mechanism. This movement, this osmotic movement, limit the possibility of embolism, that is, that can occur and block the xylem network that can occur during pathogen that infects and replicates in the xylem vessels. Another features of resistance that we consider very important for resistance is the pathogen abundance. So the amount of Xylella fastidiosa, the population size, the number of cells of population Xylella fastidiosa in an infected plants. As you can see here in grape, again, resistant cultivars has a significantly lower amount of Xylella fastidiosa that was also known in other paper from colleagues from California. And similarly, in citrus, the pathogen abundance is lower in the cultivar Navellina, which is resistant. Also in mandarin, they found no multiplication of the bacterium with also no symptoms in resistant plants, and they distinguish tolerant plants with no symptoms, but Xylella fastidiosa that can replicate. A limited, a smaller pathogen abundance was also found by us in olives, in resistant cultivars, in FS17 and in Leccino. We found up to 110 times population size of Xylella fastidiosa in the resistant cultivars in comparison with the population size of susceptible cultivars Oliarola. We are continuing these studies, and here also in different period of the year, different seasons. And you can see here an example of this in which we evaluated the pathogen abundance, the population size of Xylella fastidiosa in resistant FS17 and susceptible Oliarola in three different organs, in big wood, that means twigs, olive twigs, up to 1 centimeter diameters, small twigs, the final twigs of an olive trees, and leaves and petioles. And as you can see, in all these three organs, the pathogen, the population size of Xylella fastidiosa is significantly smaller in the resistant cultivars. The same situation was found in Leccino, in which, in addition, we also find a smaller population in the big wood. That's this should be is now under better study. The importance of pathogen abundance you can see here in these three plants that we found in the open field, also before the study were made in the open field. We found in the outbreak area three plants of Oliarola, the trunk of Oliarola, the rootstock of Oliarola, on which the cultivar Leccino was grafted. And this grafting occurred in the past, before Xylella infection. You can see here in this B member plants the Leccino branch and the Oliarola branch. And you can see by yourself the vegetation status of these two cultivars on the same trunk. We checked the Xylella abundance on the branch of Leccino, on the tissues of Oliarola of the three plants, and as you can see, the amount of bacteria that was present in Leccino was on the three plants significantly lower than that was found, that can be found in the Oliarola, in the susceptible cultivars. Now we move to the the genetic features of Xylella resistance in vitis. As I anticipated, Vitis arizonica candidans is resistant. This resistance is mapped on this PDR1 PD resistance locus. And what is interesting for us, you will see, it was that in this locus, many genes that are present are leucine-rich repeat receptor-like kinase. I will call these genes as kinase in the progress of my presentation. Why we are interested on this? Because the same category of proteins of kinase were found in a genetic study made by colleagues from Brazil in 2013, in which they found the same homologs of these genes in citrus. I invite you just to remember the numbers that are reported here, which correspond to the name of the gene, of the homologous gene in Arabidopsis thaliana. So the homologous gene of this kinase that were found in grape and in citrus are indicated with this name. These kinase are interesting for us. We did the same studies in 2016. We did the transcriptome profiling of two olive cultivars in response to Xylella infections. Of course, we evaluated the plant response of Oliarola susceptible and Leccino resistance. The outcome of this work was that Oliarola suffers a drought stress upon Xylella infection. We observed the overexpression of several genes which are linked, associated to a drought stress, are known to be associated to drought stress. While in Leccino, we found again increased in the expression of this kinase, the same that I described before in grapevine and in citrus. And what is the role of this gene? These genes are located on the cell wall of the plant cells. They are sort of surveillance genes because they react to stimuli that came from the external of the plant cells, the apoplast. And these stimuli can be MAMP, molecular associated, microbe associated molecular patterns, that means products of the bacterium, virulence factor of the bacterium as flagellin, for example, or that reacts, that are recognized by this signal molecule, this kinase, that start an immune response, transfer this information in the internal part of the cells and start an immune response. Besides this MAMP, this category of proteins, because they are large family of proteins, also reacts to DAMP, damage-associated molecular patterns. That means that once a pathogen degrades the cell wall of the plants, it produces some products, generally they are oligogaraturonides that are recognized by particular kinase receptor on the surface, and the cells perceives the damage that is occurring on its surface. Besides this field study, we also are carrying several greenhouse controlled studies in which we artificially inoculate olives and particularly the susceptible Cellina di Nardoa and Leccino, as you can see in these slides. Here the infection was performed with another isolate of Xylella fastidiosa, which is CO33, is not the same that we have on olives in Apulia, but as you can see, it's able to induce symptoms on the susceptible cultivars, while Lecino resists also to this isolate of Xylella fastidiosa. We did the transcriptome profiling of these plants, as we did before, so the RNA-seq, the gene expression of these plants, as we did before, and we again found the same category of proteins, the same kinase that we already found in the study that was performed in the open field. This category of protein is interesting because, as I anticipated you, it belongs to a large family, but in this family, a subfamily, the 12, as you can see here, is particularly devoted to respond, to recognize to bacteria components. And the kinase that we found associated to Lecino and also are present in grape and citrus, they belong to this subfamily, in which you can find some other well-known receptors for bacteria components like flagellin sensing to that reacts to flagellin. Coming back to grapevine, this is the gene organization of the Pierce disease resistance locus that I mentioned before to you. And you can see this is the gene organization that report the same kinase that we found upregulated in Lecino, the same that were found also in citrus, the same homologous that you can find. We are not alone in finding this increase of expression here. Sorry, that's not correct. But also the colleagues from the University of Lecce, they found the similar outcome. So this is a very early study that we are starting to perform. It's our ongoing working hypothesis. That came out from the publication of this paper, in which colleagues identified this MYC2 gene. This MYC2 gene is a component, is a kinase, the one that we are discussing before, is a component of the cell wall integrity sensing. And this MYC2 is exactly the same homologous that we found upregulated in Lecino in grapevine. What's the role of these receptors? The role is that to work as a sensor of cell wall integrity. Xylella has a set of cell wall degrading enzymes. They are well known, polygalacturonase, so enzymes that degrade the cell wall, and then and therefore induce a stress a damage on the surface of the plant cells. So the idea, the working hypothesis, is that these kinases are recognize this damage stress and induce a plant defense reactions in Lecino. A plant defense reaction means the production of reactive oxygen species, lignin, callose, and so on. Of course, we are continuing to study the outcome of this gene, the involvement of this gene in different cultivars, and to confirm data from the RNA transcriptome analysis. And we are also continuing to perform transcriptome studies, RNA study by high throughput sequencing in different cultivars, in the two cultivars, Leccino and Cellina, either in the field or in greenhouse. As you can see, you have here the gene response of healthy infected Leccino and Oliarola, infected with DD. DD stands for dead on, our isolates of Xylella fastidiosa in Apulia. You can perfectly see the different behavior, different gene response of the infected Leccino and Oliarola with respect to the healthy plants of the same cultivars, and also you can see the different plant response of the two cultivars. Similarly, in greenhouse, you have here the plant response, the different plant response of Leccino and Cellina. In this case, they were inoculated with the isolate CO33, so not our isolates, but they behave differently from the healthy plants of the same cultivars. And similarly, the cultivar Frantoio and FS17, they have a different plant response of the corresponding healthy plants of the same cultivars. What is interesting in this graph is also the Cellina, which is susceptible, I remind you, Cellina, the plant response of Cellina to this Xylella fastidiosa isolates, ESVL, of the subspecies multiplex. I remember you that our subspecies is POCA, is different. This is another subspecies, multiplex, which was isolated on almond in Spain. We infected in greenhouse Cellina, and we got no symptoms with these isolates. So that's to also first to show that not all, when you speak of Xylella, you should distinguish the subspecies, the plants, and so on. So you cannot broadly speak of Xylella. And according to the plant response, which show no symptoms, we observed a plant response, a gene response, which is included in the group of the healthy plants. So our transcriptome study perfectly classify this infection. Here you have another approach that we have followed to look for a feature of the plant response to the infection between susceptible and resistant cultivars, which was the evaluation of the ionome contents of plants of the two cultivars infected by Xylella fastidiosa. This is a field study in the open field. All the olive trees were infected by Xylella fastidiosa. Leccino, as expected, has less bacteria. And as you can see, the ionome, so the element composition of Leccino and Oliarola, substantially differs, either in the symptomatic tissues or in asymptomatic tissues. There are some elements, sodium, that strongly increase in symptomatic leaves of both cultivars, calcium that accumulates in symptomatic Leccino, but what was interesting for us was the increase of manganese in Leccino. Why this? Because manganese is a cofactor of several enzymes, and among the other, PAL, phenylalanine ammonium lyase, which is an enzyme which is at the start of the pathway of lignin production. And lignin was reported by colleagues from the University of Lecce as increased in the stem of infected Leccino in comparison to what was found to Cellina. Not only lignin, but also quinic acids, which is a lignin precursor. So more or less all this fits. There is a link between ionome and the presence of lignin. Of course, we are not stopping our efforts in looking for cultivars, olive cultivars resistant to Xylella fastidiosa. We have more than one field trials with a big number of olive germplasm, which of representative of the whole Mediterranean germplasm, of the whole world germplasm of olives. We are evaluating the resistance of these different cultivars in the open field. Here you have an example. You have that Leccino respond as expected, so is resistance. Is resistant in terms of, this is a study on the 2015-2019 period. You can observe that the number, either in terms of percentage of infected plants out of the total planted of the same cultivars, also in terms of score severity of the to desiccation. Leccino behave as resistant cultivars. We have other trials, and also we have additional candidate cultivars that are promising in showing resistance to Xylella fastidiosa. This to enlarge the panel of cultivars that farmers can have available to restart olive cultivation in the outbreak area. In addition, we are also starting processes of classical breeding by crossing FS17 plus Leccino, and also what I called natural breeding. This is an initiative performed with the strong collaboration of farmers in the outbreak area. They found spontaneous seedlings that resist to Xylella infection in the outbreak area. These spontaneous seedlings were isolated, they have been multiplied, and now they are under evaluation by artificial inoculation or by infection by Viruliferus fineus spumarius. Epidemiology and resistance. This is a very interesting point of our study. I like this because it links the epidemiology and resistance. At the end of our previous paper, this one, we concluded telling that a lower bacterial titer of the cultivar Leccino suggests that it may also exert a beneficial impact on the epidemiology, as it may result in a lower rate of Xylella transmission by Phylenus spumarius, thus helping with the containment of the disease spread. What does it mean? If you consider the transmission of an infectious agent, you are plenty now of these terms, basic reproduction number during this time of coronavirus infections. The basic reproduction number indicates the number of individuals that can be infected by a single individual. This is a simple description of the transmission of an infectious agent, in which you can, the hypothesis was that if Leccino has a lower pathogen abundance, has small bacteria in its tissues, it would be able to transmit less than the Oliarola, which has more bacteria. This is a warning. These are not real numbers. We have not calculated the basic reproduction number of our infection. It's only to, as an example, to explain you our working hypothesis. The working hypothesis that was tested in the field in which susceptible and resistant olive cultivars in two different plots were caged with Phyllenus pumarius. And then we evaluated the percentages of branches on which Phyllenus pumarius tested positive after the acquisition access period, after the acquisition of the bacteria. You can see that the percentage of Phyllenus pumarius that tested positive after the acquisition was less in the resistant cultivars, therefore proving our working hypothesis. After the acquisition access period, we also evaluated the transmission rates of of the bacterium by the same viruliferous Phyllenus pumarius. As you can see here, there was a smaller, significantly smaller, limited transmission of bacterium from the resistant cultivars Lescino and FS17, which was smaller than the transmission that occurred from Cellina and Calamata. Now I'm moving to the end of my presentation. Why do we say resistance? And not because there are is not a semantic story. So there are definitions. You can find this definition in some of this manual or paper that I reported in the bottom of these slides, that indicates that a resistant plant is able to limit the pathogen replication. So the pathogen abundant in resistant plants is limited. Of course, the symptoms are limited, while a tolerant plant is able to contain the effects of the infections regardless of the pathogen replication. Tolerance means that the pathogen can replicate without any limitation, but symptoms are not so bad. That means tolerant. While immune means that the plant does not allow at all the infection by a specific pathogen. Finally, this is a disclaimer. With these slides, I anticipate some of your question about this. We have no data about the agronomic performances, the yield of Xylella infected resistant cultivar. So if you ask me how the Lecino produce in the field, I cannot ask you because we are plant pathologists, so we wait that agronomists perform these studies to respond to these questions. And also, we do not guarantee the stability of resistance throughout the time of the Lecino. That's all. So this is my last slides. I should thank all my colleagues that allowed me to give this talk, this seminar. It's a group. We were not able to perform all this study alone. And also, I want to remember Professor Giovanni Martelli, who inspired and stimulated us in our work and was really an example for all of us. Thank you to all. I finished my presentation. So the first question is from Stephen White and Fabrizio Cillo. Presumably, Xylella sidiosa is present in the root. So why there are no blockages in the root causing wall plant death? That's an interesting question. Indeed, we find Xylella fastidiosa in the reeds, but unfortunately, There are, to the best of my knowledge, no studies about the presence of Xylella in the outcome of Xylella in the root. We know that Xylella move with a twitching mechanism in the opposite way of the xylem flux, and we plan, unfortunately, to perform such studies in the roots, but we're not able to perform these studies. I'm sorry, but I cannot answer to this question. The other question is from Luisa Torsi. How important is the sensitivity, the detection limit of the assay of Xylella to get information about the resistance mechanism? Of course, the sensitivity of a method is very important. So the other problem that we face when we work with woody plants, big plants as olives, is also the erratic distribution of the bacterium in the plants. So you should not consider not only the sensitivity of the meters, which is important, of course. We currently perform this by quantitative real-time PCR. It's a very sensitive method, but you see the erratic distribution of the bacteria on the plants. So also the sampling, the way of sampling, has a big role in the diagnosis of the bacterium. The other question, again from Luisa Torsi, is another aspect that could be very interesting is to give you an independent method to study the integrity of the membrane. Of course, if you have another methods to evaluate the integrity of membrane, methods that are known are generally electron microscopy methods that can evaluate the status of the cell wall internally in the xylem network. Question 3 from Ashraf Ali. Is the general health of resistance varieties still good? Can it suddenly collapse? Normally, I showed these photos. Normally, these plants behave better than the susceptible cultivars. Of course, you cannot, as is known in biology or in agronomy, you cannot give a response yes and no. What I can show you are the photos that I presented in my presentation. They behave good, but of course, the management of the lecino, the way of cultivation also is important for a better management of these plants. Normally, they behave better in terms of vegetation status with respect to susceptible cultivars. Question 4 from Blanca Landa. The index of desiccation that we use is for 0 to 5. That is related. I don't remember the percentage related to each severity index, but it's related to the percentage of plant that affected by desiccation. Question 5 from Giovanni Bubici. It is interesting how xylem vessel diameter is related with resistance. However, this evidence is in contrast with another pathosystem. In olive Xylella, ricino resistant and non liarola, contrast with ricino resistant in non liarola e frantoio as well, is susceptible. incontrasi in noli verticillium in other vascular pathogen, leccino uguale susceptible, and frantoio is resistant. This scenario could be studied in detail to definitely assess whether xylem vessel diameter is a resistant determinant. Regarding these vessel diameters, this study came from parallel indication, if I remember well, in Graven, from another pathogen. It should be Chlamydosporium, something like this, that establish this link this link between vessel diameters and resistance. Of course, perhaps it was not clear in my presentation, you cannot consider, that's our also experience, what we are learning in this infection. You cannot consider a single features of the resistance or susceptible mechanism. There are surely there are other mechanism and that altogether can concur to the resistance or to the susceptibility. Indeed, I'm reading. Blanca responded to Giovanni. Resistance, what I think, is a pathogen to a pathogen is the sum of many factors. We cannot consider a single factors as responsible. That's the vessel diameter can be just one. Indeed, we don't find the smaller vessel diameters as I anticipated in FS17. But indeed, it's interesting this contrasting behavior of Leccino frantoi to Xylella fastidiosa. Fabrizio asked, is there a running study on the genetic basis of resistance in olive, similarly to what observed in Vitis arizonica? Yes, we are performing these studies. We are evaluating the role of these genes, of these kinase in a model system in Arabidopsis thaliana. We are collaborating with people, this expert on the field.
There is a last question.
Potential use of resistant rootstock. If you consider the example that we have in the field, the example that I showed, the B member plants in which you have Leccino and Oliarola, there's not my feeling is that there is not the possibility of protection because from the microbiome point of view, there is no transfer of bacteria to the upper part. In my idea, as a rootstock is difficult to work, while it can work as a grafting on the rootstock. Because what we, this is a feeling, where the damage occurs is in the small twigs, in the small twigs of the plants. So perhaps as a rootstock, it does not work, but grafting of Leccino resistant cultivars on a susceptible rootstock can work. We indeed have a project, Resixo, that is evaluating the upper graft of resistant on susceptible cultivars. The question from Elvis Gerges, did you check in details the upregulated genes if infecting a susceptible olive to pauca with subspecies like multiplex? Not yet. These are very ongoing, very recent studies. We should go better in depth in the analysis of these new libraries that we have. In this, Lorenzo Leon, in this example, the rostock was susceptible. You asked for the rostock resistance. I showed rostock susceptibles, and on the upper part, the resistant cultivars. Lorenzo Leon, regarding crossbreeding, you must know that most of the seedlings from crosses are useless from the agronomic point of view. So I would recommend testing for Xylella fastidiosa at the last stage of selection. We are also producing progenies from Lecino and FS17, crossing and open pollination in Spain. I know, Lorenzo, it would be very useful for the progress of our studies. And Maria contributed, Saponari. Hi, Lorenzo. Unfortunately, we had field observation that grafting susceptible cultivars on resistant Lecino, used the rootstock, we did not observe resistance onto susceptible scion. Lorenzo Leon, last comment. Most of the studies, histological, transcriptomic, ionomic, are based on evaluation of only one single resistant and susceptible cultivars. I worry about making generalization. I strongly recommend to check the results in a group of cultivars of each resistance category. Of course, Lorenzo, but this is in our project. So what I showed you in one of my slides, that we are evaluating the role of this gene in different cultivars. Giuseppe Pappagallo, thanks so much, Pasquale. Do you think to deepen the investigation on other traditional cultivars, Coratina in particular? Coratina, unfortunately, seems to be not resistant. We are deepening the investigation. We have Coratina and a lot of other varieties under investigation. As I told, we have almost all the germ plasma of olives, which is present in the Mediterranean area, in the field under evaluation.
It's time to thank, first of all, Pasquale Saldarelli for his very interesting contribution. Then I want to thank all the people working on XF Actors project, and I want to thank you, of course, all of you that joined and interacted with us this morning with your comments and questions. We remember that a recorded version of this webinar will be available on our website, on XF Actors project website, in the next day. And so thank you again, and thank you again, Pasquale.
Thank you, stay home.
Stay safe, and stay human too. Okay. Stay human too.
Okay, see you, hope to see you soon. And thanks again.
See you in the next webinar in April. Thank you very much, everyone. Bye.
Bye. Ciao.
Ciao.